A. Byron here from HobbyKing.com with today's daily. I have another new airplane to show you today. This time it is a mid-size or smaller size wooden 3D plane. So this is pretty neat. It is all built up balsa and ply, of course. And this is more of a traditional style airplane, but with a bit of a modern twist on it, which is cool. I don't know. Everybody likes a wooden plane. They're different from foam. They fly differently. They look very nice with the nice covering on them. And this kind of just reminds me of back in the kit days, you know, or the ARF days of wooden airplanes. We didn't really see foam options out there, so it's pretty cool. You can see here they've got see-through covering. It's a pretty traditional or pretty common type of 3D airplane scheme that you would see. So just overall, very neat look. The build quality is excellent on this. It's very, very nice and extremely lightweight. And that's what I mean with a bit of a modern twist. They're using the newer style of building, which is just really minimalistic as far as the use of the ply in the build, and it makes the model very, very light. So it's excellent for 3D flying, and of course, great for sport flying as well. You know, it's not just only a 3D model, but it will lend itself very well to 3D because it does have large control surfaces, as you can see. Same with the elevator and a giant rudder, which is very cool. And you notice the size, side of the fuselage is very flat, very tall, so that's great for knife edge. Just overall, really fun airplane to fly. Now you can also see, when I mentioned a modern twist, this has carbon fiber undercarriage, which is very cool, so lightweight, very strong. And it's got the little fiberglass wheel pants on it, which is nice. Just overall, really cute little airplane. It's going to be at a great price. So what you'll need for this to outfit it, if I was setting this up, I'd probably go with like a 28mm, maybe even a 35mm, depending on what you're wanting to do with it. Outrunner motor, put a good size prop on it, probably a 12 or a 13 inch prop, and 25 to 35 amp ESC, something in that range. And it's going to be on a 3S battery. The factory recommends about a 1500 milliamp, so you could probably go all the way up to 2200 depending on what type of flying you plan to do with it. You're going to need four servos. Just uses four micro servos, so you need one for each aileron, obviously, one for the elevator, one for the rudder. So pretty simple setup, guys, and easy build as well. It's two-piece wing. And the canopy comes off. It's just magnetic. Pull this off here. And you can see you've got plenty of room for mounting your electronics inside. And overall, just a neat little airplane. So anyway, guys, check this out. Coming very soon. As usual, you'll see it on the new items page. So keep your eye out for it. And you'll be able to find all the related electronics, such as the servos, power system, etc., in the related items tab in the product listing. So check it out, guys. Thanks for watching.